Hello, are you unmuted? Yep. Okay.
Hello, Rob.
How are you?
Just fine, fine.
I'm so
Perfectly
glad
fine.
you're here, and I'm so glad that you guys have agreed. We've talked about EFL talks for, well, since I was in Russia last year. So I'm very excited you're here, and I'm excited that you're going to be here again on the 25th. So.
Okay. Thanks, Rob. Thanks, Rob.
And
Okay.
let's see if
So,
you can share your slides.
yes, just a sec. Are they visible?
Yes, they are. And okay, so you're ready to go?
Yeah,
All
exactly.
right, you got 10 minutes on the clock. Take it away.
Thanks, Rob. Thanks. So, hello, everyone. My name is Evgeny Usachev. And today I'll be talking about some steps, five in particular, to implement blended learning format or model in your teaching practice. So let's start first with the idea of blended learning. On the screen, you see that blended learning is sort of combination of offline and online teaching. And each part has its strong points. If we speak offline learning, we keep in mind motivation issues, personalization, feedback, fluency and listening, relevance, and of course the issue of discipline. On the other hand, when we mean all online learning, what comes to our mind is mobility, it's structure, tracking and control, self-study, reduced course, and global reach. So the point is how to get the best of both worlds when we teach in the blended learning model. So in my talk today, very briefly, I'll share my ideas, the five steps I mentioned to implement it. Okay. So typically blended learning has a few components. So we blend face-to-face training with sort of virtual classroom or LMS opportunities, webinars, different links to useful resources, some sort of simulations, different forms of assessment, and of course, last but not least, it's one-to-one coaching, be it offline or online. So if we speak about particular steps which we need to take to switch into blended learning format. So what comes to my mind, first of all, to decide on the learning platform or learning management system. So some of them are absolutely free to use and they are available, such as, for instance, Moodle or some other platforms. Some are quite, I would say, customized, especially if we speak about publishers, Pearson, Longhorn, Cambridge University Press, or Macmillan, for instance. They've got their LMS systems, and in my experience, they work pretty well. So you need to decide on one or several platforms just to start this blended learning experience. So the second step here on the technical side is just to decide on the textbook with online workbook you are planning to use. Again, online workbook and online components give nice opportunities for automatic monitoring or checking and assessment. So, as well as that, we need to decide on different online services for supplementary activities, just to give students more opportunities. In my experience, I use Edpuzzle, which is a nice resource for video and listening activities, Quizlet for vocabulary development, and some others. And of course, we need to decide on the proper channels for communication with students. In my experience, I use Telegram if I have a group of students, or WhatsApp, or just the internal communication tool within LMS. Okay, so just the first step, some technical issues. Step number two is organizational step. So, and we need to decide on the ratio, first of all, between online and offline components. So, in our language school, I work for, it's 50-50, but it all depends on the learning context depends on the students and depends on the situation. So you need to decide what was the ratio. Yeah, for instance, 20% offline, 80% online. Of course, depending on your goals and objectives. Then we need to decide on the assessment tools online. Most of the assessment is done these days online because it saves time and there are nice tools you can use. Again, usually I use those who are in LMS system, publishers, for instance. And having decided on the ratio between online and offline components, we have to decide on the activities which we do online and offline. And I believe it's very important decisions, a teacher's decisions. So what focus should he concentrate, or what focus should he or she give on something done online and offline? Okay, so it should be so mutually helpful. And very important issue, informing parents, if we speak about kids and teens or clients, that we are planning to implement the system, especially if they have never faced the blended learning model before. Step number three is pre-teaching. I included some points here. First of all, it's very important to have step-by-step guidelines for teaching in this format, in the blended learning format. So first of all, to guide ourselves and to guide our learners and maybe their parents as well, just to have a clear idea what we do. A good list of additional online services and resources will help everybody involved in this process, as I mentioned before, learners and parents. And it's not enough just to make a list of these activities and services and resources, but it's very important to decide how to use them, how to implement, how much time we give to each activity, no matter if it's face-to-face or online format. Step number four is dealing with parents or clients. Again, before we start, we need to clearly explain all the advantages of blended learning, because some parents are a little bit worried about online components, or they just don't want to have any online component in their kids' learning. Mostly the reasons are there's just their beliefs that online learning doesn't work as well as offline one. So a good solution is mixing, blending them. Then it's very important to show the opportunities that online textbooks or workbooks give. It's better to have a webinar with parents or clients and to show all the features of such an opportunity, of such a tool. And it's very important to have a script of how to deal with parents. We need to define possible objections to this format and prepare responses to them, okay? And last but not least, it's just the methodological set of steps. So as I mentioned earlier, selecting a textbook depending on your teaching context. So textbook for both offline and online. A good mix works well if you have a printed book to have in the offline class, face-to-face class, and an online workbook which is used to assign homework and to check homework. From my experience, it's a very good mix. I believe it's vitally important to schedule your lessons in the blended format, at least for a month or a couple of months, to understand how you will be progressing and inform the students or clients, right? Scheduling is a key issue. Before we advertise, say, a textbook or a course, we need to explore the opportunities of a digital textbook and the opportunities it gives, right, ourselves. And some practical steps, which I also experienced. So give a trial lesson to your peers, see how it works, and of course, get a feedback and improve. So these are the common steps which I'd like to share with you. So I have a few seconds to speak. It's a moment for a sort of promotion. You know that on the 28th of November, we have the biggest ELT event in Russia, which is called Trendy English 9 Online Conference. So it will be fully online and will start as soon as 5 a.m. Moscow time and finish as late as 5 p.m. Moscow time. So if you are in a different parts of the world, you're welcome to join us. So Rob will be with us, by the way, and he'll make a speech at this wonderful event. And there is early bird prize, which expires very, very soon, 9th of October. So you may sign up by this link, trendyenglish.ru conference 2020 and the English version of it. So that's what I wanted to say. Thank you, Rob. So I suppose I was within time limit.
You did perfectly.